Today in the news, we got some AMD APUs and some Intel branding. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with AMD. A little over a year ago, before the Ryzen 2000 series CPUs were even released, a desktop roadmap revealing the codenames for upcoming AMD CPU families were leaked. For today's news, we'll need to break it down real quick. First, we learned about Matisse, basically the Zen 2 CPUs that we're all waiting for. Then, we learned about Picasso APUs, which we've talked about in the last few weeks, thanks to a chiphell forum leaker who apparently has a few of them in hand. In that same roadmap, we also got what looks like the 2020 plans for AMD CPUs, Zen 3. We got the codename for it, which is Vermeer, and we also got the codename for the next gen APUs, which is Renoir. Alright, so now that we have the roadmap broken down, let's talk about APUs. So far, they've always been a generation behind in terms of CPU architecture. Ryzen 2000 APUs were based on the first gen Zen, and the third generation APUs are based on Zen Plus. But what about graphics? So far, all we've seen is first gen Vega graphics on both generations. So when is it going to change, and are we going to see Navi on APUs anytime soon? Well, this is where some research by Komachi comes in. It seems like Navi might not come to desktop chips, at least not in the near future. In the latest Radeon software for Linux, a reference to Renoir was shown with the identifier GFX909. As we know, Navi's identifier starts with GFX10, which means no Navi in the Renoir APUs. On the bright side though, I don't think that Renoir will stay stuck to Vega 10 graphics. The identifier for Vega 10 is GFX900 or 901, and Vega 20 is GFX906 or 907, which leads me to believe that GFX909 will be a Vega 20 variant. So Renoir will probably be a Zen 2 based APU with Vega 20 graphics, likely in a chiplet form factor. This information goes against the leaks that we've seen last year about Ryzen APUs with Navi graphics, but unfortunately, those code names and identifiers all come directly from AMD drivers, so it's pretty legit. Personally, I'm still not losing hope at seeing a desktop APU with Navi within the next year or so. AMD might have it in the works and are simply not counting it in the Picasso slash Renoir APU family. What do you guys think? Would Vega 20 be enough of an upgrade in an APU? Next up, with Intel, it looks like the branding for their upcoming Comet Lake CPUs is set to 10,000. It's quite heartbreaking, honestly, knowing that Intel could have used the 10th generation as a branding event for their first 10 nanometer mainstream chips, but it's not going to happen. Anyways, leaks are coming left and right, with Komachi leaking the Comet Lake U series with the i7-10710U, the i5-10510U, and the i3-10110U. I wonder if that's how Intel's gonna say it. Is it gonna be like 10710 or 10710 or maybe 10710? I don't know, but 10710 makes the most sense to me. These CPUs show a 6-core processor in the U lineup, which isn't surprising, given this is pretty much Intel's only upgrade path. Graphics-wise, it looks like this generation will still stick to the GT1 graphics, which means that no upgraded graphics for Comet Lake. Quite a bummer, honestly. And lastly, going back to AMD, it looks like motherboard manufacturers are getting busy posting a list of compatible boards for next-gen Ryzen CPUs. Both MSI and ASUS now have their compatibility lists ready, and it looks like a common board for both manufacturers isn't gonna make the cut. If you own a B350, B450, X370, or X470 board, you should be safe. If you decided to go for an A320 board early on, you might be out of luck. It's not all bad though, since the newest boards might have features that you want, like tons of PCIe lanes for all the USB 3.1 that you want. Personally, I think I might make the switch to X570, although I will wait to see if my B350 board becomes a problem. Anyways guys, that is pretty much it for the news today. Hopefully you've enjoyed. If you do have any questions, don't hesitate to drop them in the comment section down below with the hashtag boot sequence. As always, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Oh wow, I pressed something on the keyboard.